instead of my life. Swear I was born right in your way. I was out in the rain, so everything changed last spring. Blankets on the beach. Yours is the first face that I saw. Think I was blind before I met you. I don't know where I am, I don't know where I've been, but I know where I want to go. So I thought I'd be these things take forever, I especially slow. But I realized that I need you, and I wondered if I could come home. Strange, you said everything changed. You felt as if you just woke up. And you said, this is the first day of my life. I'm glad I didn't die before I met you. But now I don't care, I could go anywhere with you. And I'll probably be happy. So if you want to be with me, if these things there's no telling, we just have to wait and see. But I'd rather be working for a paycheck than waiting to win the lottery. Besides, maybe this time is different, and I really think you're like me.
So Emily and Anna can take that. So but Anna doesn't need to be where we are.
What time does Jim need to be here to take us?
You guys should be out of here at 10:30. I'm going to be out of here at like 10:15.
Okay.
But the room needs to be like ready to go so that they can move my stuff for me.
I've never once reminds me of why.
Why
you cut your hair? That's right.
This is a secret.
I need to be really long. Yeah.
So when we get there, Jeff will...
Oh, okay. Excuse me.
That's right. What do you need?
I need a lipstick from my purse somewhere in the depths of it. There's a Marc Jacobs lipstick. The front, yeah, I think
this one curls so, nice.
So here's what needs to happen if you want to help me. Mm-hmm. So this stuff does not curl, so the solution is take a little bit of the real stuff, and then do like a little braid, this easy braid, and then tuck that. Thank you. And then tuck that like up.
Yes, that's cool.
So you want a little break?
Okay.
So,
oh! That was a quick delay. I just realized that camera was on me.
Do you think I should put on the new bra? Or is it fine?
Do you have a makeup bag, Lindsay?
All the bridesmaids should have a clip-in. Someone doesn't. There's an extra one over here. You don't have a flower clip-in.
Yeah, no, I need to sing for the recessional playlist. please. Okay? You got that?
Just because we're standing.
That's the table?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. Oh, I never sewed the other hook on the top.
I mean, there's still a pattern there, so.
Is there?
Maybe we should bring
the needle and thread?
Yeah. Yeah, at least in the
well, everything, I mean, we can put that somewhere.
Yeah. And I don't know how you want to tie your thing. You want
to
tie you want a big old bow.
Mom, can you do the bow?
You
got to turn sideways.
You guys are making me nervous.
Yeah, I'm not.
Stop talking about it.
We got the spotlight.
I'm like, I'll
first
you
get
to
it together.
What are you talking about?
I'm just gonna tie it.
First,
you have
oh.
to find the square
Mom, can you find the
blue earrings?
Mm-hmm. And my blue rose.
Yeah, they work really well, actually.
Love it.
No, they'll work better than the curling iron.
Yeah, I'll be good.
You just do spiral and pin it to your head. But she did rags.
There's a joke about coming out of the closet here.
Yep.
What did you do?
Oh. It's just hooked in.
On there?
Yeah.
This, do you think it's going to stay? Hold on, I just want to do like a surgeon's knot and then clip it
okay.
and see if it'll stay. Oh, look at that burst.
Should you tie nice. The pearls in a surgeon's knot?
I mean, it's
no,
just looping
just
them over
slack.
Itself. Oh, wait
one
last.
Just 1 second. I'm just trying to have enough
okay.
snacks so I can do this.
Oh yeah. All right, that'll work. Hold on.
Excuse me.
No, it's right here. I used one of the pasties to stick it to me. That's what they're there for, right?
Ridiculous. For cheese.
Okay. So we got bobby pins. We got extra bobby pins.
And this
and goes with two.
Okay.
Maybe you should come.
When you guys are
at
okay, number one, can you guys can you unfreeze stuff
off the
top?
Everybody else.
Yes. Let me just
unpeel.
Because
yes.
that
way
you can.
Unpeel the.
Yeah. It is. Yeah. I couldn't remember.
They still have it.
I need to check it out.
I don't think they have that one.
Oh, probably not this one, no. This was
I really
from
like that one.
Too.
You got a custom size? I ordered a couple that are not custom size. And they're like, well, they're just big on me.
Yeah.
So I need to make another. I mean, those were two that were on sale.
Okay.
So I think maybe
yeah.
I couldn't even get a custom order on them.
I'm just not good at looking at something in a picture and going, yes, that
yeah,
would look good on
have to
me.
Try it on because
yeah.
the proportions
mm-hmm.
could be wrong.
Yeah.
You guys look super cute.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I love a tea brown.
Mm-hmm.
Here comes Jeff. We're going to be doing first look in a couple minutes. Jeff and Ivy. Looking good, man.
Thanks.
Wow, I love that tie.
Thank you. Good day, man.
Good to see you.
Good day.
Hey.
Hey, Ivy. Okay. All right. Let's do this.
Let's
Let me give.
Yeah.
You need a piece of tape?
Yeah, something like that.
Ivy! Sit. Hey.
Good girl. Good girl.
Good.
Oh, is she coming? Is she coming?
Tell you, right?
Is she coming? Stay. Stay. Stay.
All right, looking awesome. Henry, you'll need the backup there.
No. Hey.
Oh my gosh, look at you. Oh my gosh. Look at that.
Yeah, oh. Wow. Oh my gosh. It's not pink.
This is just this.
It's not pink.
We'll fix it before we go out in public.
Okay. Okay.
Ivy, come here. Hey, beautiful. Hello, doctor. Hello. Is today going to be fine? Is today going to be fine?
I was freaking out because I couldn't find her collar.
Oh, I have it.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, maybe I will reapply later.
Yeah, maybe you should.
Maybe just for the ceremony.
Oh, you got a line.
Then you'd be in.
Oh, did she?
Dirty is not gonna happen.
Well, you know, you gotta have the rain.
Hey!
Hey! How's it going?
It's fine.
So for
good
our
to
vows.
See you. Thanks.
For our vows, can we read our ketubah?
If you would like to, absolutely.
I feel like that.
Three words.
Okay.
Be'ene.
Be'ene.
Elohim.
Elohim.
Ve'adam.
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 You waste it.
Okay, yeah, but I forgot the first one as soon as I said the
second
one.
You don't have to remember it. I'm going to say it.
Oh, well, that's fine.
I'll say the whole thing out loud. You know,
okay, that's fine.
When you give it the ring. So
okay. I even got, like, the mic, too, so, like, like I'm special. And you need, yeah, you're, like, my bodyguard.
You're, like, wow.
Well, you need, like, a Jeffrey, way too large American...
Oh my god.
Talk about a last minute worry. Sorry.
Yeah, but it keeps falling down, so I'm trying to trail, and we went through the tunnel, and Uncle Scott had this light on his bike, and it wasn't, like, he wasn't walking fast enough for the energy to make it bright. So all I remember is walking through this really dark tunnel with this, like, really terrible light, you know? With our bikes, and I'm like waiting for something to come. No, we lived in Brooklyn in South Baltimore.
You sure it's for me? I've been coming out to this part since I
just gave her that.
Not where we want it.
like if trust. I put my keep on. Just like if
this
I
is,
put the keep
I'm gonna
on
gonna like,
in here.
Put, like, and pin it to your eyelashes. Alright. Alright.
That was cute.
The phone in my hand.
Thank you.
And it's the ring dog. Oh, what a nice new collar.
We're not actually signing it, but we're signing it because we made it together, so. I signed it the other night when we were working. There we go. Okay, miners are here, so we can get started. I think you got your thing. All right, we're good.
I got the thing.
You got the thing?
I got the
thing. I got the thing.
I'm good to go.
All right. All right.
Okay.
Fine.
All right, welcome, everybody. I'm Rabbi Mark Novak, and I've had the pleasure of knowing Lindsay and Jeff for, what, 5-6 months?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
all right. That we've been meeting on occasionally, you know, once a month. And it really has been like an amazing journey for me. And an honor to be with you both for this amazing time for you both. If you haven't seen the ketubah yet, if you want to step around, you'll notice that the ketubah is all in English, and that might be due to the fact that Lindsay's Hebrew calligraphy is not quite up to par. But there was their choice for it to be all in English, which is just fine. The ketubah will be read later at the ceremony itself. As a matter of fact, they will read it, which is rather uncommon for the bride and groom to read their own ketubah. But you are uncommon, so it doesn't surprise me that you made that choice to do so.
In the best way possible.
In the best way possible.
So one unusual aspect of the signing of the ketubah is we're about to sign something that we are witnessing something that hasn't happened yet. So how does that work? It's kind of like a legal fiction in a way, in that we are going to just assume we're going to have the confidence that unlike in the Parsha, the Torah reading last week, where the earth opened up and swallowed up a man named Korach and all of his followers, that's not going to happen today.
It's Los Angeles.
or Los Angeles would be the modern equivalent to that, I suppose. And we certainly are blessed with an amazingly beautiful day. Yesterday would also have been a wonderful day to get married, except for that it was Shabbat, so it wasn't going to happen in any way. But the rains have subsided and have departed to rejoice with you both as well. So there is another time when we actually do something in Jewish tradition. Before actually the event has occurred, and that's when we're lighting Shabbat candles on Friday night. So the practice of lighting Shabbat candles is to say, in Jewish tradition, you say a prayer, and then you do the thing, right? So it proceeds, and it kind of puts the seal on what we're about to do, and it opens up kind of like an energy field for us to mindfully and intentionally do something. So on Shabbat, when you light candles, well, if you say the blessing first, then it's already the Sabbath, and then you're not supposed to light candles. You're not supposed to light fire on Shabbat. That's if you are among the most observant of Jews. And so the practice is, since, well, you can't say the blessing because it's already Shabbat, then you can't light the candles, you can't do the action after that, is that we cover our eyes. Right, we light the candles first, then we cover our eyes and say the blessing, and then we open our eyes. Ah, it's like a miracle, amazing. The candles are lit, right? So in a way, it's a little way around. But what really it's all about is our intentionality of bringing Shabbat in, and our intentionality now is to bless you. Is to bless you.
Yes, that's our intention.
And for us all to be a part of the blessing that is today. And so some of you, I don't know who you are. I know the miners are. Your name?
Sue.
Hi, Sue. And?
Dave.
Welcome. Thank you so much. So we will sign the ketubah. Ketubah is from the same root for the word for writing, so it's a document. And then it'll be sealed by our having witnessed what we're about to attest to in a short while from now. Okay, so I want to read the ketubah now. It'll also be read under the. You want to read it?
No. Go ahead.
Under the chuppah, so that you know what you're signing. On the first day of the week, the 11th day of the month of Tammuz, in the year 5775, and the 28th day of June in the year 2015. For those of you who don't know, this is a beautiful work of art created by Lindsay and Jeff. Actually, with your hands. That is unusual. The beloveds, Jeffrey Stephen Holloway and Lindsay Fundakowski Feldman, in Hebrew known as Leah Bat Shachar Bat Sadiq, entered into mutual covenant as partners, loving and supportive companions in life. The exchange of rings under the chuppah before God and witnesses symbolizes our commitment to each other as beloved and friends. We will treasure and respect each other with honor and integrity as we create a loving future together. May our love provide us with the determination to be ourselves and the courage to pursue our chosen path. We affirm our intention to provide for each other the protections and privileges of all loving couples. May our lives be intertwined forever and be as one in tenderness and devotion. As we share life's everyday experiences, we promise to strive for an intimacy that will enable us to express our innermost thoughts and feelings, to be sensitive at all times to each other's needs, to share in life's joys and hardships. Together, we will build a home warmed by the delight of the Sabbath and Jewish tradition. We commit to the creation of an inclusive society. By the way, what a wonderful week to have to be signing this document,
yeah.
Given what transpired on Friday. A loving environment dedicated to peace, hope, and respect. A family rich in love and learning, goodness and generosity, comfort and compassion. And I want you to know as well, something that the document doesn't say, and their intention to raise a Jewish family together. We joyfully enter into this covenant and accept its obligations.
Dave is my witness, and I think Tiffany is Jeff's.
Tiffany is my witness.
Yes, we
can. I get a witness? I need the plastic.
Oh, move the plastic.
Hello. Wait.
Whoa.
Carry. Oh, there they go.
I got it.
No, that's not what I was looking for. I need those.
That's it.
Yeah, forget it. I only need two.
We got it.
I'm good.
Got it.
I'll figure it out. No, that's for the kippah.
So there's one other part to this before we let them go for more pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Is when our ancestor Yaakov, when Jacob met his beloved Rachel, he knew immediately that she was the one for him. And it must have been the way that he looked at her that caused her to perhaps blush, and then to veil herself in modesty. So we have maintained that tradition for, 3,500 years or so, to do just that. Now, some people explain this ritual of the veiling, the bedecken, as one where that's a result of the fact that Jacob, if you know your Bible, if you know your Torah, he ended up not marrying Rachel at first, but rather Rachel's sister Leah. That perhaps there was a little trickery involved, or perhaps of course Leah was the firstborn and it was in her right to be married before her younger sister. But in the morning when Jacob woke up, he found that he was lying beside not the one he wished to betroth, but her sister. And we don't want that to happen. And so...
Where's Emily?
Not workable.
So as you can see, today is going to be laced with symbolism. And symbols have meaning. As a matter of fact, for me, sometimes symbols have more meaning than anything, because they touch a deeper place in us that perhaps are more ancient and eternal than anything we can possibly name. So, if you would turn to each other and look in each other's eyes. Holding hands is also a good thing. Jeff, as you're looking at Lindsay, is this the woman who you desire to marry?
Absolutely. Absolutely, yes. Yes.
And Lindsay, looking into your beloved's eyes, is this the man that you wish to marry?
Absolutely.
So first, Lindsay, if you would take the kippah. So this was their making of creativity, that Jeff not only would veil Lindsay, but Lindsay would keep her. I don't think it's a verb, however.
Yeah, it's a turn.
Okay.
Go farther back, sorry.
Okay.
You want me a little bit?
No, we're just gonna try it.
Okay, alright.
We're just gonna go for it. Oh man.
Just make a corner.
One of the things we did not practice in my office.
My god, this is worse than my signature.
So now, Lindsay, if you would turn to your parents, and Jeff to your mom. These are just a few moments for you to bless your child. In private, quietly, nothing out loud, in any way, shape, or manner you'd like to. It could be in the form of what you wish for them today, next week, for their future. If you want to peek into the future, that's fine. If you want to look into the past, that's fine too, and draw upon, most importantly, your love for each of them. And again, any which way, any in any shape, form, or manner this blessing takes, that's up to you. So you can hold hands, put hands on, either way.
Okay.
And you don't have to say it loud.
You were about that high.
Uh-huh.
When did you get so big?
You keep saying that.
When did you get so big?
I don't know, a long time ago.
Thank you.
You'll all have opportunity to bless them later. What's that? I said that they'll have the opportunity to bless them.
No, I'm just in a good mood. No, I'm just in a good mood. I'm getting married today. Yeah.
Did you get my kids?
Yeah, you woke. Yeah, so you like wake up, and I'm like, I'm trying to sleep.
It's not even text. Oh, wake up.
Yeah, I the plan was to sleep a little bit longer, but everyone kept texting me. You were texting me. She was texting me. My friend Chris was texting me. So I was just like, forget it. I'm not gonna be able to sleep.
Why bother? Just get up. So but that was like at 6:30.
Yeah. So I want to make sure who's in charge of the ketubah getting to the.
Sigmund Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Sigmund Tuff, Sigmund Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Sigmund Tuff, Sigmund Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Mazel Tuff, Sigmund Tuff, Yehelanu, 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 O Lord of Israel, Yehelanu, Yehelanu, O Lord of Israel.
This one's now. Hold on.
Where the ceremony is going to be. Shelter 104, the party is going to be in 105 to the left.
I'm Rabbi Mark Novak, and it is an honor to be with you all here today. As you can see, we are about to begin because I have a groom standing to my right. Or should I say, a good-looking groom?
Yeah.
So there's a couple of things that I would like to ask and to tune you into before the ceremony begins. First of all, I would like to kindly ask on behalf of Lindsay and Jeff, if you have a cell phone and it is on, to turn it off. We would appreciate for you to serve in the capacity during the ceremony as edim. It's the word in Hebrew for witnesses. And in order to be a witness to something, we need to be attentive. And so there will be photographs and there will be film. Well, not film anymore. Live video, thank you. And later on, of course, you're free to take pictures. But for the ceremony, we'd like you to refrain from doing so. Okay. A couple of words that I'm going to need you to know during the ceremony. One is a word, one is a phrase. Please, you all familiar with this word, please say amen.
Amen.
Okay, do I hear an amen, somebody?
Amen.
Oh, I like this. You said it was going to be a nice crowd.
Yeah, I told you.
Excellent. And the other one is after Jeff later on breaks the glass and I'll remind you, it's Mazel Tov.
Mazel Tov!
Right, and if you're Israeli, you can say Mazel Tov, all right? Last but not least, I would like to teach you all a melody. This kind of melody is called a nigun, which basically means a melody without words. Gonna need you later on to help me sing it, and so that's why I'm teaching you now, and so it'll be familiar later on, okay? And there are two Hebrew words that go with this as well. So the melody goes like this, repeat after me. Yai da da da, yai da 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 da.
Yai da da da.
And then we're going to sing two words, Ma Tovu. Say Ma Tovu. Which basically means how good it is. For those of you who remember Jackie Gleason, he used to say that all the time.
Right.
So if you sing it like this, Ma Tovu. Sing that.
Ma Tovu.
Ma Tovu. Ma Tovu. Ma Tovu. Let's do the whole thing. And yai da da da, yai da 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 da, yai da 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 da. Oh, you can sing too. Yai da da da, yai da 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 da, yai da da da. Further ado, marriage is what brings us together.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? What's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. Rainbows have nothing to hide. So even though, and some choose to believe it, I know they're wrong. Wait and see. Someday you will find it. A rainbow connection. The lovers, the dreamers, and the dreamers.
Good girl.
Who said that every wish would be heard and answered? We wished on the morning star. Somebody thought of that, that someone would believe it. Look what it's done so far. And what's so amazing that keeps the star gazing? What do you think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, dreamers, and me, all of us under the spell. We know that it's probably magic. Have you been half asleep? Have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name. Is this the sweet sound that calls the young sailors or this might be one of them to say. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find a rainbow connection of lovers, dreamers, and me.
Welcome to those of you who have come in the name of God, in the name of all that's good. Mi adir al hakol, mi baruch al hakol, mi gadol al hakol, uyevarech echatam La Kala. May the source of greatness and the source of blessing and the source of power bless the bridegroom and this bride. Let me hear an amen.
Amen.
It's just warming up. Zehayom asadonai nagila v'nismachavo. What loosely translated means, oy, am I glad it was not raining like it rained yesterday. The photographer told me a story about a bride who was up to her ankles in mud. But you're up to your head in joy, as well as you are, Jen. What it really means is, this is a day unique that shall never has been and never be again. A day that rests in eternity, created by a great mystery that we cannot name. Let us rejoice in it. And that's what we were going to do. Rejoice in this day. Wine accompanies all happy occasions. There is an expression that says, Yayin nichnas, v'sodo yotze. That wine goes in and secrets come out. But there is no great secret today that Jeff, you love Lindsay. Lindsay, you love Jeff. There is no great secret that you have amazing community that have come from near and far to be with you today. The seven circles, three of which Lindsay made around Jeff, and three of which you, Jeff, made around your beloved, and the one that you made together. Seven circles representing seven, the number of perfection, 6 days leading up to the day of rest. Seventh day, according to our myths, the day in which God rests. The moment of perfection. A moment we can go, ah, all that needs to be, all that we need is here, right here. The number seven, seven circles, in which they created an inner circle, pun intended. An inner circle that now you can look out at your outer circle, some of whom are very close to you, some of whom are a little further away. I don't mean just logistically. Beloveds, family, friends, friends and family, all encircling you as you encircle them, each other in love. So excuse me, because I want to go get there. So what's going on up here, if you can hear, is the top of the chuppah is rubbing against Jeff's head. Now, it's okay, because Lindsay made this talit that is forming the chuppah, the wedding canopy, in college, and it's been waiting for this moment to arrive. Those are nice lyrics. Maybe they should be in a song someday. And the poles, you gathered in New Jersey somewhere. They harvested the poles for the chuppah. And so this is truly a man and woman made wedding, created and presented. If you want to step just a little bit further, there you go. Because that's going to bug you, I know. I know you, Jeff. That's good. So a traditional Jewish wedding ceremony actually separated the moment of engagement to the moment of betrothal by a full year. But these days, because caterers cost so much and we don't want to be hanging out for that long, it's been conflated into two different blessings, one part. So traditionally, the first blessing talks about relationships that are permitted or not permitted to each other now that you are going to be married. I'm going to be chanting and singing a riff on that. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Asher Kirshanu B'mitzvotav V'tzivanu Lidvok Zo B'Zo V'Liyot Levasar Echad V'Yasar Aleinu Acherim V'Yiti Lanu Et Nisuot Lanu Al Yedei Chuppat V'Kiddushin Baruch Ata Adonai Mikadesh Amo Al Yedei Chuppat V'Kiddushin Blessed are you, Eternal, our God, you who permeate every nook and cranny of the universe, who makes us holy through your commandments, and instructs us and gives us permission to cleave one to the other and become as one flesh, and forbids us to any other, and permits us to the one who we marry by means of chuppah and kiddushin, holiness. Blessed are you, O God, who makes holy God's people by means of chuppah and kiddushin. The rings are where? I know a dot. No longer on the back of our furry friend, eh?
Right.
Would you please give Lindsay the ring that she'll be giving to Jeff, and Jeff the ring that he'll be giving to Lindsay? Lindsay, you can just put that in your left hand for a moment. And just hold it.
Oh, no, hold it.
Yeah, that's it.
Sorry.
This is the ring that you're giving to Lindsay. Right? This is the ring you're giving to Lindsay. Just put up your pointing finger. And Jeff, if you would say these words to Lindsay, not to me. My wife would be very upset. You ready? Look into it. Behold. By this ring.
By this ring.
You are consecrated to me.
You are consecrated to me.
As my wife.
As my wife.
Be'enei.
Be'enei.
Elohim.
Elohim.
Ve'adam.
Ve'adam.
In the sight of God.
In the sight of God.
And humankind.
And humankind.
Put the ring around in front of you. Show it to everyone. And you can transfer. They are married. You can say, woo-hoo. That's great. A wedding without laughter is like, you can fill that in later, let me know. Lindsay, Jeff, put up your pointing finger and say these words, Lindsay. Behold,
by this ring,
you are consecrated to me as my husband.
You are consecrated to me as my husband.
Ve'enei Elohim.
Ve'enei Elohim.
Ve'adam.
Ve'adam.
In the sight of God.
In the sight of God.
And humankind.
And humankind.
And they're still married.
Yeah.
this is the first wedding I've ever officiated at where the couple made their own wedding contract and framed it. And now it's my honor to hand it to them to read for you so you know what's in it, because you're the ones who are going to need in the future to keep them to this contract, right? For those of us who have been in relationships, we know it's easy to forget sometimes.
On the first day of the week, the 11th day of the month of Tammuz, in the year 5775, and the 28th day of June in the year 2015, the beloveds, Jeffrey Stephen Holloway and Lindsay Fundikowski Feldman, Leah Batshachar Batsadi, entered into mutual covenant as partners, loving and supportive companions in life.
The exchange of rings under the chuppah before God and witnesses symbolizes our commitment to each other as beloved and friends. We will treasure and respect each other with honor and integrity as we create a loving future together. May our love provide us with the determination to be ourselves and the courage to pursue our chosen path. We affirm our intention to provide for each other the protections and privileges of all loving couples. May our lives be intertwined forever and as one in tenderness and devotion.
As we share life's everyday experiences, we promise to strive for an intimacy that will enable us to express our innermost thoughts and feelings, to be sensitive at all times to each other's needs, to share in life's joys and hardships. Together, we will build a home warmed by the delight of the Sabbath and Jewish tradition. We commit to the creation of an inclusive society, a loving environment dedicated to peace, hope, and respect, a family rich in love and learning, goodness and generosity, comfort and compassion.
We joyfully enter into this covenant and accept its obligations.
Amen.
Amen.
And it has been signed by several witnesses before you all, before the ceremony. It is said that hold on. That's okay, you never did this before.
I'm gonna lose the paperwork.
That a chatan, a kala, a bride, groom, and a bride should never live for a moment in their household without knowing where the ketubah is, right? And you should always have it nearby in your possession, except for at this moment that you can now give it to, which is what you were about to do.
Thank you.
Seven blessings, Sheva Brachot, 7 days of creation. This chuppah, and Lindsay and Jeff standing underneath it, is symbolic of perfection, really. And in one of these blessings, we're going to be recalling the Garden of Eden, a perfect place until something happened. But for this moment, and until Jeff breaks the glass and leaves this moment of perfection, all is good, all is perfect. And in order to help to raise the joys of this moment, I'm going to call upon six friends of Lindsay and Jeff, who are going to be saying, not really a translating, a direct translation for some of them, but unpacking the meaning of these seven blessings that I'll be chanting in Hebrew. So, is everybody right here?
Who's?
Okay. If there's some of you in the back, would you come forward now? I just have a seat or stand over here. I'm going to be handing each of you the microphone, and if you would come and just stand next to Lindsay and Jeff when it's your turn to do so, that would be wonderful. Who's Dave? So who's going first? Okay. Dave, if you would just come over here. Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Borei Pri HaGafen.
Amen. Blessed are you, one ruler of the universe, who created the fruit of the vine and also the wheat and hops barley.
You know who wrote that one.
Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Asher HaKol Bara Lichvodo.
Blessed are you, one shaper of the world, whose divine hand has touched all things.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Yotzer HaAdam.
Blessed is the one who created human beings. May your marriage support you both as you experience the entire range of humanity and come to know yourselves and each other.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam Asher yatzar et ha'adam b'tzalmo B'tzelem ha'demut ha'tavnito B'hidkin lo mimenu b'nyan ha'deyad Baruch atah Adonai Yotzer ha'adam.
We bless you, God, for forming each person in your image. You have planted within us a vision of you and given us the means that we may flourish through time. Blessed are you, Creator of humanity.
Sos tasis letagel ha'akara b'kibbutz b'nei ha'letocha b'simcha Baruch atah Adonai Mesameach Tzion b'vaneha.
Israel, once bereft of her children, now delight as they gather in joy. Blessed are you, God, who lets Zion rejoice with her children.
These
loving friends taste of the bliss you gave to the first man and the first woman in the Garden of Eden in the days of old.
Blessed are you, the presence who dwells with bride and groom in delights.
Amen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Asher bara sasa b'simcha chatan v'kala Asher bara sasa b'simcha chatan v'kala Gila rina v'tisa v'cheta Ava v'achava v'shalom v'reihu Meva Adonai Eloheinu Yishama Be'avei Yehuda Uvechutzot Yerushalayim Kol Sasan Ve'kol Simcha Kol Katan Ve'kol Kala Kosasan bekosimcha, kochasan bekochala. Mol mitzalot chatanim mechupatam, unarim mishtehei neginatam. Baruch atah Adonai, mesameach hatan.
The white. You do the white.
Blessed
are you who lights the world with happiness and contentment, love and companionship, peace and friendship, bridegroom and bride. Let the mountains of Israel dance, let the gates of Jerusalem ring with the sounds of joy, song, merriment, and delight. The voice of the groom, the voice of the bride. The happy shouts of their friends and companions. We bless you, God, who brings bride and groom together to rejoice in each other.
Amen.
Amen.
So now this is the time I'm sure you've all been waiting for, which is the rabbi's remarks. I know a rabbi who speaks for 45 minutes on Yom Kippur, and he tells the ushers, lock the doors. But I promise not to keep you that long. Yai-dai-dai-dai, yai-dai-dai-dai, yai-dai-dai-dai-dai-dai. Again. Matovu, 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 matovu. You've got a choir here.
Yeah.
The angels have descended, or they were here all along. And sometimes it just takes us a moment to open our eyes to recognize that there are angels in our midst. Every week we read from the Torah a different portion. And in the week that we are in now, there's an amazing story of a man whose eyes open to an angel. But it takes an ass, a donkey, to open his eyes. He's a prophet by the name of Bilam. And he is on his way, as instructed by his boss, Balak, to curse Bnei Yisrael, to curse the Israelites. You know? Everybody has to earn their living somehow. And he's on his way, and he comes to this place in the cliff where he can't get by because there is a donkey, like his donkey, right? And the donkey refuses to move. And he speaks very harshly to the donkey, and the donkey says, what did I ever do to you? Haven't I always been there for you? Well, he gets into arguments back and forth until finally his eyes open and there's an angel with a fiery sword standing in front of him. Can't wait till the movie comes out. This is a great moment, right? And eventually he's able to make his way, but he realizes something is going on if there's an angel in his midst. Perhaps he shouldn't be cursing these people. Perhaps he should be blessing. And when he does come to the time to curse these people, out of his mouth comes Ma Tovu. What you just said, this blessing. He blesses the people instead of cursing them. He says, Matovu Ohalecha Yaakov, how good are your tents? How good are your tents? And this is a beautiful tent. And how good is your dwelling place? And perhaps he's talking about inside. You know, because there's a part of the Torah where God says, make a dwelling place and I will dwell within it. Make a holy place. And that's right here in your heart. So this is a special tent. You harvested the poles, you made the talit, and it represents the home that you are going to create. Now, what will that home be like? It will be a home, I know, filled with friends, invited over sometimes for Shabbat dinner. Dinner prepared, perhaps, Lindsay, by you, and a home readied by Jeff.
Because as you, Lindsay, are only too quick to point out, Jeff is the better housekeeper of the two.
That's true.
So together you'll fulfill the mitzvah of haknasat orchim, of inviting in and welcoming guests. Ma tovu, how good will be your tent. Yai dai 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 yai dai 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 dai. Ma tovu ohalecha Yaakov, how good is your tent. Your home will be filled with quiet moments. Picture yourself, as you shared with me, things you like to do, sitting next to each other, reading science fiction or a fantasy novel. It's no wonder that it was while watching The X-Files that you had your first kiss.
Very romantic.
Your tent will be filled with love and reading and study and dog. Your tent will be filled with appreciation for each other. Here are some things that Jeff said about Lindsay in one of the times that we met. She is understanding of my flaws. She's loving and caring even when I'm sick or in a bad mood. She is patient. She loves Star Wars and all things nerdy. She likes NPR as much as I do. She is forgiving. She's a great dog mommy and is great with kids and will make a great mother someday. And Lindsay, here are some things you shared about Jeff. He's a sensitive guy with an artistic streak. He lives with intentionality. He's compassionate. He's supportive of my passions. We share the expectation to work through hard things. He's handsome and charming, present in the moment, while I am a frequent worrier. He's profoundly silly, often hilarious. He takes pride in making Friday nights reason enough to do a family dinner. Here's Jeff, this non-Jew, who's happy to be along for the ride and sees the beauty in the rituals that I observe. Just as is this non-Jew, this prophet, who blesses the Jewish people in the desert oh so many years ago, Matovu Alecha, so do you bless this tent, Jeff, and bless this holy union between the two of you. But we see it's an open tent, open on four sides, because that's where you come in. I guess that's right, that's where you come in. I've never thought about that before. So I want to ask of you as the Edim to affirm and confirm a number of things. Say the words, I do. If you notice, there was no I do in this ceremony. This is for you to say, I do. Do you, individually and together, promise to support Jeff and Lindsay in any way that you possibly can?
I do.
Do you promise to be a good friend?
I do.
Do you promise to offer advice when asked to do so?
Did they say I do?
They did. Right. Do you promise to share both good times and hard times?
I do.
Do you promise to share laughter and tears?
I do.
To share a good beer?
I do.
Matovu Ohalecha, how good is your tent? Extended beyond your home to include family and friends. Yai dai 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 dai. Ma tovu, how good it is. Ma tovu, how good it is. Ma tovu, how good it is. Ma I just need to acknowledge that the breeze that just blew through, one of God's names is Ruach. We know, referred in other traditions, the Holy Spirit. In the Jewish tradition, it's the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, and the wind, as if to say Amen, just blew through this tent.
Wow. There's two more things to do, one of which I have the honor to ask for God's blessing to both of you. And then they will break a glass. After which you will yell,
"Mazel tov!"
with a lot more conviction. Oops. Just a bit of logistics. If you were in the photos, if you are family and fake family and friends, you know what that means. Stay close for photos after we go out. Some of you are going to need to come back. Okay. Lindsay and Jeff, if you would bow your heads, hold each other close. Yivarech Adonai v'yishmerech. May the source of all life bless you and guard you. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yichunecha. May the face of all that is good and compassionate and righteous and kind raise its face to you and be gracious to you. Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yisein v'cha shalom. And may God lift God's face to you and grant you wholeness in the peace that is found in coming together as husband and wife, Chatan Kala.
Amen.
One last thing to do, which is to break the glass.
You're stopping that?
Oh, no, he's got the shoes.
Good shoes for that.
So there's lots of different explanations for the breaking of the glass. I like this one. That in coming out of the perfect place, Jeff and Lindsay are going to be entering what we know to be an imperfect world. A world that is in need of much repair. We acknowledge some of the repair that happened this week as a result of honoring all people who wish to be married in holiness and to be together, to raise families and to share their lives together. And so there's a lot more work to be done. And this is the broken world. And may your marriage last only as long as it would take to gather up each individual piece by hand and to put this glass back together, which is gonna be forever.
We're going to do a special ritual where we say a blessing over the challah, or the ceremonial bread here. And let's do this together. All right. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. All right, Bon Te Avon. We have Steve coming up.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they're going to do some speeches, it seems like.
What?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah. Yeah, let's move forward.
But we don't.
Hi there, everybody.
Hey, Steve.
Hey.
Hey, Steve.
Good afternoon. And
In case you don't know me, I am Steve Feldman, and if that doesn't ring a bell, Lindsay Feldman, former Feldman, partial Feldman, is... Is one of my lovely children, and I hope you don't mind, but in the true 21st century tradition, my speech is on my iPhone, so please allow me to proceed, because if you don't want me to ad-lib this for 15 minutes, you really don't. And by the way, I'll have you know that I'm wearing this kippah, not only because today I feel religious, because my daughter is getting married in the Jewish tradition, but because this thing doesn't fall off my head like those other ones do. And that's an advantage. So anyway, I am in awe today that today I'm standing here celebrating with my dear family and friends the marriage of our Lindsay to Jeff. Thank you so much for coming here from near and afar to share in the joy. 29 years ago, Betty and I were blessed with these twin baby girls. Where did the years go? First, Emily finds Anna, Brian has Angie, and now Lindsay is coupled on this day to Jeff. The promises, life's gifts, the nachos, not nachas, nachas, which is the Yiddish term nachas, for the pride and joy brought to the parents by their child. All of life's pleasures are coming to us on this day. So Jeff, as you've discovered, whatever Lindsay will do, you know she will take it to the end. As a young child, Lindsay delighted in nature. Camp Schmidt, working at the Kafka Nature Center, summers at the Delaware beaches, catching fireflies, Fred the Boxer, Prune the Great Dane, many cats, but especially her favorite, Pumpkin. The guinea pigs, forgot their names. That snake, I think it was Normie. Tweety Bird, the cockatiel, and of course, Cuddles the Great Parrot, who bit everybody in the house, except Betty. And remember Lindsay's birthright Israel journey? She's the only one of our immediate family who's made it to the promised land. So, yay for Lindsay. Also, remember the giant Sequoia's RV trip, road trip with Mom, I, Emily? That was fun. The Appalachian Trail. Lindsay loves the Appalachian Trail. The Delaware Water Gap. Blairstown and Outward Bound, where you, Jeff, gratefully stole Lindsay's heart. So that migration to California turned out to be Lindsay's sad departure from Maryland, but not for long. Suitland Art gave her a solid foundation. Little Shartikva congregation in Prince George's County, and yes, the Steins, the Sheldons, they sparked Lindsay's quest to become an observant Jew. California gave Lindsay an introduction to the world of fashion. See, she's wearing vintage flowers today from the millinery shop she frequented in the LA Fashion District. Wherever Lindsay visits, she touches the life force and it grabs and energizes her. And who would guess that this fibers major would become a teacher and incorporate all her nature knowledge, honeybees, and Spanish and art, and give back to the Baltimore youth her exuberance, talent, and love of life. Yes, Lindsay embraced Southern California, but Maryland longed for her spirit, and she answered Maryland's call. Thousand Oaks is a nice place to visit, but Baltimore is home. And home is now complete with Jeff to embrace her. So this wedding celebration is pure Lindsay and Jeff. Woodland wonder around us, native flowers, including wonderful Pennsylvania hydrangeas from Sylvia and Ed, and the loving flower arranging from the family and friends. Lindsay's found a loving Jewish community and she has discovered that this ancient religion is not just a hand-me-down obligation, but another gift to accept and a culture, a blueprint of life to live by. Jeff, I know you will care for Lindsay and treasure your relationship. Thank you for taking care of our dear. You are a strong, dedicated, and caring man, and my sweet Betty and I are ecstatic to entrust you with Lindsay's heart. We are very happy to have you as our son. And let's be grateful to medicine, the healing arts, which has given I and Betty a lifelong career, but also especially that Betty is here to share in the joy of the wedding due to the skill of an angel in the guise of a neurosurgeon. And let's be grateful to Hashem, or whichever higher power you believe in, for bringing us together on a June day. So I say, L'chaim, to life.
All right. Thank you.
Phenomenal human beings, and that's owed a lot to their parents. So I just, for a second, want to thank them. Because without you, I wouldn't have them. So, thank you. I met Lindsay at the Princeton Blairstown Center. It was her first job out of college. And the fun thing about the Princeton Blairstown Center is not only do you work very intimately together, but you also live together as well. And so Lindsay and I instantly became friends. I think within the first week of her starting working there, we started a garden together. We spent several hours blueberry picking, cherry picking, then canning what we had picked. I actually really started learning how to can with Lindsay. We made lots of jam. And so over time, I got to know her very, very well, my dearest friend. And then Jeff came along. What was really interesting about Jeff moving into the house, I actually wasn't living there anymore, but what was really interesting about Jeff moving into the house is that I, even though I had known Lindsay for several years and had such an intimate friendship with her, got to know Lindsay so much better with Jeff around. I had no idea she liked X-Files. Turns out that's where their first kiss was, watching X-Files. I had no idea she even liked X-Files. She would have talks with Jeff out on the porch for hours. And what was beautiful was that, really for the first time since I'd known her, Lindsay really started talking about and thinking about the person that she wanted to be, what she wanted from life. And I really attribute that to Jeff. I don't feel like she was changing for Jeff, but it was as if I was starting to see her grow. And it was a really, really beautiful thing. And so, I would like to raise a toast to Lindsay and Jeff. My prayer for you is that you continue to grow together. Cheers.
Thank you. been in Florida for the past 13 years. And unfortunately, I've missed a lot of Jeffrey's adult years, missharing with him being so far away. But I can truly say I am so proud of the man he's become. He always has made me proud. As a girl, you know him as a man, he has made me so proud. And Lindsay, even though you and I have only met briefly, we've talked many times on the phone, we talk often. And through these conversations, I've come to admire you and to love you. And I thank you so much for choosing my son to take this walk through life with. I wish you all the happiness in the world.
And like I just have a story, I don't really have a speech. So it goes like this. I met these two back in 2011. At that time we lived in a house together. We worked together. I think it was some weird social experiment that occurred from one of my bosses my former boss was sitting in the back. So there are three things that happen in life when people ask for things that they want, or they pray, or they anticipate. You get three things. Either you get what you want, you get what you need, or you get what you get. So in this instance, when we lived in the house, you know, we couldn't pick who we wanted to be with, so we got what we got. But we did get what we wanted. We wanted employment. Yeah. So, at the time, I had to figure out how I was going to deal with so many outlandish personalities. So we have Jeff. Jeff, at the time, was coming from another gig, and he was very antisocial, but professional. He, 9 to 5, that's it, I'm done. Have a good day. While everyone else socialized in the house, Lindsay was the type A. She had the list of things she wanted to do. She wanted to advance her career at the time, settle down, marry a nice Jewish man, have some babies. That was her thing. That was her thing. Both had their own tunnel vision. So we had a couple conversations. I got to know them. They got to know me, as well as our fourth roommate in the house. Hey, Chris. And I think once we all kind of got around each other, got comfortable, we started to open our minds, and for the most part, we lost our tunnel vision. I feel like at times we have certain things that we feel like we need to accomplish, we need to get done. We are stuck on that one thing that we miss all these other opportunities that occur. And in this instance, this could have been a missed opportunity. But I think the more that they became open to each other, eventually they fell in love, and we have the sight of that today. So at the end of this story, the two lovers got what they needed, and they needed each other. And scene. That's all I got. All right. Yeah. Cheers to you, my friends.
So I'm not going to do a speech because I don't do speeches. Not this way. I'm going to actually introduce the new couple as their first dance. And so you're going to come up here and dance. And then I'm going to play some music for everyone else to dance to. And you're going to dance. Or else.
Yeah.
Making Samaritan change their spring. Blankets on the beach. Uses the first space as on. Think I was blind before I met you. I don't know where I am, I don't know where I've been, but I know where I want to go. So I thought, yeah, these things take forever when I especially slow. But I realized that I need you, and I wondered if I could come home. As if you just woke up, and you said, this is the first day of my life. I'm glad I didn't die before I met you. But now I don't care, I could go anywhere with you, and I'll probably be happy. So if you won't be with me, there's no telling, we just have to wait and see. But I'd rather be working for a paycheck than waiting to win the lottery. Besides, maybe this time is different. I mean, I really think you're like me.
Everybody who traveled to get here. There's a lot of people that came a lot of miles to make it all the way out here to Baltimore and areas nearby. And we've had a lot of days to get ready for this wedding. Like, you don't know. You just don't know. You just don't know. You just don't know what the last few days have been like. I've been busy with like work and class. And in the meantime, Lindsay and her family have been taking care of so many details and taking care of, I would come home from work and I'd open the door and there'd be people there and there'd be things happening and all kinds of stuff being accomplished, and then I'd be the one that'd be like, okay, let's go have fun and hang out and go chill out. And so I was very blessed to be able to do that. And then when my folks got into town, we started hanging out with them. So it's been like a lot of getting together with folks all week, which has been great. There's something that I want to say though, like apart from all that stuff, like Tiffany hit the nail on the head. Like, there's a story behind where Lindsay and I met. And it all happened at PBC. There are certain people here who know that story, and they know how we met, and the day we met, and the minute we met, and the person who actually introduced me to her is sitting right there in the red dress, and I'm very thankful to her for introducing. Oh, this person also lived in Maryland. Oh, this person also is a climber and all kinds of stuff. And, oh, you'll get along. You'll get to know her. And at the time, I was like, yeah. Good coworker. That'll be interesting. Driving up the interview, I was like, "Well, that's good. A lot of good coworkers." But we met. There were four of us that met at this house, and it was me and Lindsay and Tiffany Brown and Chris Traynor, who's sitting right over there. I'm so grateful that we have like our group here today, because like there were times where I'd be pulling Tiffany aside, like, "Hey, like." So this girl, Lindsay, what do you know about her? Yeah, and and I'd be getting details from Tiffany Brown about Lindsay, and she'd be like, oh, you know, like, are you into the Jew thing? I'm like, I could be. I really could be. I'm cool with it. I like Monster. Chris had to put up with us at times too. We'd be sitting there like watching Netflix and all kinds of crazy shows that we would watch, and holding hands, and he'd like do this and make fun of us. So like, I'm just really grateful our like group, like our family is here, and our supervisors are both here, the ones that probably put up with us the most. Like, they're talking about it. I was like, what are these cats up to? And I'm like, oh my God, you see them looking at each other at the lunch table today? Because we were not the best at hiding it, but we were very professional. And getting to work with Lindsay as a facilitator has been one of the greatest blessings of my life. Like, I got to see a side of her that I really cherished in myself, which is like being an instructor and working with students, because that was my experience as a kid. I was lucky enough to be exposed to that as a kid. And she had the same passion as me. And I knew immediately that we had a lot to talk about. And we could spend a long time talking about that stuff, and that's what I really hope to do. I've gotten to see a lot of sides of her. She's taught me about bees. She's a beekeeper. She taught me about a lot of stuff. I'm just really grateful to be here right now with all of our friends and family here as well, and all the people that I've gotten to know over the past couple of weeks who I didn't get to know or I haven't known very well. And I'm really grateful my family's here. They came a long way. Megan helped out a whole ton. Thank you, Megan. You're the best. That's all I really got to say. I just wanted to say thank you so much for everybody for showing up. It's a blessing, so thank you.
Set that high. So most people get engagement rings, and Jeff got an engagement dog. She's here right now. Her name is Ivy. Everybody's met her, I'm sure, because she's like sniffed you and begged for food from you. And I think that in getting Ivy, so literally I got Ivy, and then I drove to Peggy's house, which is Jeff's grandmother, because Jeff was at work, so I have, you know, no pressure, just go pick out our dog. So I go, and this puppy's nice, and this puppy's nice, and they all smell really good, you know, so it was really hard. So I finally choose a puppy, and get the puppy, and I go to Peggy's house, because I know Jeff's not going to be home anyway, and Peggy gets to meet Ivy before Jeff does, and I pick up Jeff's mail, which is a common thing, because Jeff used to live with Peggy. So I pick up his mail, and I get home, and I'm like, and he finally gets home and meets the puppy. And he's like, hey, was there a package? And I was like, what are you talking about? There's a dog here. Like, I got you a puppy. And I didn't know at the time that in the package was an engagement ring. And so he got a dog, I got a ring. I don't know if it's fair necessarily, the dog, like, she poops and she eats and stuff. The ring is fairly low maintenance because it's got a diamond and stuff, so I appreciate that, but, you know, one way. But I think that our story is really great, and it's been just such a joy and a treasure getting to share living in a home with you and having a dog with you and just being normal people after... you know, after being recovering instructors. So it's been wonderful, and we just have to say that it's such a blessing. Like, we have so many blessings that yesterday we were able to sponsor Kiddush lunch for like 150 people at our synagogue, and we had an Ofrev to celebrate us, and then so much family came out last night to the Blue Pit barbecue, and then we've been blessed to have everybody out here today. So we just really appreciate it. And the greatest gift that you all can give us is to enjoy yourselves and enjoy each other, and play some giant Jenga and some ladders and some cornhole and drink. And I think there's going to be ice cream soon. So we got custom ice cream made. I don't know if you guys know that, but there's cake too. But I recommend that we eat the ice cream soon. And then we'll do some dancing, all right? So if you guys could do that for us, we'd really appreciate it. Because, you know, I got this dress on, so I can ask you to do whatever I want. So thank you so much in advance for all the time. Thank you.
giving you icing.
Okay, all right.
All right, ready? You ready? One, two.
Yeah.
Jack.
All right,
big kisser, guys.
Bye. All right.
Gross. Somebody said gross. Okay.
Not that you guys really want cake because you had a lot of ice cream, but.
Nah, whatever. She's looking at us.
I know. Bye-bye. If you're right
Bye.
Here.
Bye.